Some pride, I have done the state some service. The USS Enterprise was launched with those words on the 3rd of October, 1936. She didn't disappoint, becoming the most decorated ship of World War II. Of course, that simple fact doesn't do justice to the pain and horror she witnessed. One of her blackest days came on the 7th December, 1941. I received an urgent radiogram that said simply, "Air raid on Pearl Harbor. This is not a drill." We had been operating under war conditions for 10 days. But the attack still came as a surprise. Finally, we entered the war that had consumed the world since 1939. We are now at war with the Japanese. They're striking at Pearl Harbor as I speak, a cowardly sneak attack that has the potential to cripple our sea power in the Pacific. Our options are limited, but we'll have to do everything we can. We have a patrol, Bravo flight, in range of Pearl. Those boys will have to do everything they can until we get there. Our goal is to buy time. The enemy will want to cripple a significant proportion of the docked fleet. Our job? Is to reduce that proportion.
Arizona is under pressure from torpedo bombers. Take down as many as you can.
Fire! That's one less.
if you're lucky, on the ground. Artillery and fuel tanks, on the ground. Watch out for flak.
I got her.
Enemy.
target.
With the losses sustained at Pearl, our capital ships are either sunk, disabled, or in retreat. This leaves carrier war as our only option. Our duty as the crew of the Enterprise is clear. We're approaching the Marshall Islands with the intention of destabilizing Japanese occupation. We then intend to disrupt enemy supply routes by eliminating Japanese cargo vessels. The enemy has demonstrated the power of its carriers. It is now our turn to show what we can do.
Thank you.
are the hangars and fuel tanks. If you get shot up, let your wingman take the strain and get back to the Big E ASAP.
Wake Island used to be one of ours, till the Japanese occupied it after the attacks on Pearl. Hell, we brought some of the Wake Island personnel here on this very ship. Now they're either dead or held prisoner by the enemy. So we're gonna do something about it. This is the kind of thing carriers were made for. No drawn-out bombardments to make ready for a ground assault. we can just hammer the bastards back to the Stone Age with dive bombers and American grit.
up the good work.
We'll be right back.
past, fate has appointed her. I think we can confidently conclude that all wasn't lost in Pearl Harbor after all. Above, on, or below the water.
It's time to attack Japan. The goal here isn't to kill them all. We're still a ways from that. But we want to show the enemy that they don't have the Pacific all to themselves. And we want to send a message back home to say to the American people that Pearl notwithstanding, we aren't down, and we sure as hell aren't out. The Enterprise is supporting B-25 bombers launching from the USS Hornet. The B-25s can't land on a carrier, so they'll be passing straight on into China. Each bomber only gets one pass, you hear me? We only get one run per plane. Discharge the payload, then it's on to the next plane, okay? Okay, let's do it.
First things first, get the planes in the air and target the enemy patrol boats. We've got to make every B-25 count, so let's clear the way.
Here.
free. Let's get those babies in the air.
As you know, the enemy is launching a major offensive on the Solomon Islands. Carriers Yorktown and Lexington with escort are on course to intercept. It looks like Hornet's not going to make it. We on the Enterprise are going to give it our best shot. This is a major test, men. Enemy carriers Shokaku and Zuikaku will be present, maybe more. This will be the first time we or anyone has waged carrier-on-carrier combat. The Enterprise is only as strong as her crew, so for her sake, we have to be stronger than the enemy. We absolutely cannot afford to lose the Enterprise, but striking a severe blow to an enemy carrier is too great a prize. We can't hold back. Good luck, men, and Godspeed.
Your eyes on the target and trust your luck. ears are ringing. The Shikaku is maneuvering, so we're bringing in the dive bombers. Get plenty of altitude and dive straight. Make that payload count.
goner.
Battle of the Coral Sea, the first great fleet battle was ended. On the 8th of May, 1942, the USS Lexington, having taken torpedoes and bombs, was scuttled by her escort. Many of the Enterprise's pilots had trained aboard the Lexington, and her loss was strongly felt. Even as we mourn the brave men who had lost their lives during the past months of conflict, we felt pride in what we had achieved. The importance of aircraft carriers could not be doubted. The Enterprise had excelled. The crew of the ship and the air group that took to the skies to protect them felt ready to face whatever challenge the future might bring. Six months into the war in the Pacific, the importance of carriers was clear to both sides. The Doolittle Raid had intensified the Japanese desire to cripple our carrier power. So they set us a trap at Midway Atoll. As if to prove the depth of the war effort, our codebreakers cracked the Japanese code. We knew where and when they would strike and planned a counter-ambush of our own. Enterprise would fight alongside the Yorktown and Hornet against four of the Japanese carriers that had struck at Pearl Harbor. We didn't think of it as revenge. It was survival. The fate of the Lexington was still fresh in our minds. We knew that we couldn't afford to give up carrier power to the enemy. The Enterprise could not be lost.
One left.
the Enterprise. This is bad news. The Midway air crews will have to fend for themselves.
Midway, gentlemen. We consider this outpost an essential component of our Hawaiian strategy, especially since Pearl. Our codebreakers think the enemy intend to feint towards Midway to draw out our forces, but we know enough to turn the tables on the Japanese. In terms of carriers, we're up against their flagship, the Akagi, as well as the Kaga, the Hariyu, and the Soryu. We must respect their forces, if not their goals. We're outnumbered. Hornet and Yorktown are with us, but Yorktown's badly damaged, so keep an eye on her. This is a big one, men. Let's get out there and show what the Enterprise crew can do.
Increases ours.
Reinforcements from the Hornet are inbound, and Yorktown's looking strong.
Enemy AA fire! Torpedo away! I'm in his sight! That's a hit!
Big.
I'm in his sights. Releasing payload. Bomb impact good. I'm under fire. Bombs away. Bomb impact.
The Akagi is sunk. We got their flagship. What a blow we just struck.
No sign of the boys from the Hornet, but we've word that the Yorktown's crew took out the Suriyu. So that's two for our team. Akaga's next.
enemy.
Yorktown, however, was not so fortunate. She came to the battle already damaged, and that last assault was too much. We must pray for her crew.
Thank you.
The Solomon Islands are essential to our supply strategy. It looks like the Japanese are concentrating what remains of their carrier force here, after the trouncing we gave them at Midway. Our priority is to keep the Enterprise afloat. Even though the enemy is weakened, our position is tenuous. Do not get complacent. Some of you may have talked with surviving members of the Yorktown, transferred here after the loss of that ship. Their loss is our loss. We must not lose another ship.
Thank you.
now.
We intend to pursue. The elevator's still out, but the deck's been welded sufficiently to be functional, so you can come on home. The Enterprise is fully functional once again. She won't be 100% until we can reach a dry dock, but all aircrew activities are to resume.
Let's find us some Japanese and let them know who they're dealing with.
Thank you.
Solomons or die in the attempt. It looks like it's the Enterprise versus Japan.
The Japanese are attacking Guadalcanal with ground forces, but it seems that the boys at Henderson are pushing them back. It's down to us to disrupt the enemy air support and sea power. The battle for Santa Cruz is deadlocked at this time. We lost the Hornet, which is a major blow, but the Japanese are unable to gain any ground. We may be able to inflict enough damage to force them to pull out. Our priority is to keep the Enterprise afloat, but we have to make our stand here. Both forces have suffered significant losses. The Enterprise herself is badly damaged. All we have is prayer and grit.
Escort the bombers to their targets. Keep an eye on your ammo. Remember that we have deck delays.
Not be relied upon. Deck delays are killing our launch efficiency.
on target. That rocks the Shokaku.
Enemy?
Enterprise has incoming. The elevators are moving again, however. We should be able to launch a defensive squadron.
Alpha Squadron, defend the Enterprise.
Thank you.
air group commander's in his bunk getting his 3 hour sleep. We're flying at night to identify the enemy force, but there's allies out there too. Take out the enemy searchlights, but try not to hit our ships, okay?
The Japanese are mustering another assault on Guadalcanal. Last time, they went the ground route and were pushed back. This time, they've brought in the Hiei to bombard Henderson from offshore. This means that the Hiei is our primary objective. But the Enterprise is really hurting. We're held together with prayers and hope. The only thing that can pull us through is the fighting spirit of the crew. Get out there, sink those bastards, and come back home alive. That's an order.
Fired upon! in his sight. Bombs away. That's a bomb hit. Releasing payload. Bomb impact good.
Good job. The transports are taken care of. Hayes, your priority now. Keep her busy until the B-25s arrive. The HEA and her escort have very heavy AA defenses. To preserve planes and lives, use long-range torps. We're going to try hitting her with torpedoes from long distance. Stay clear of the AA fire.
Fired upon! target sight. That double A's big. That's a hit. I'm in his sight. I'm going down. That double A's big.
A big thanks from Enterprise to Henderson. Glad you made could make it. We softened the Hiei up, but I'd surely like to see her under the water.
It's a miracle that the Enterprise has survived the Solomon Islands campaign. We've taken Telugi, pacified Santa Cruz, and secured Guadalcanal. It's Enterprise versus Japan, and by some miracle, the Enterprise appears to be winning. The only way the enemy can salvage this campaign is to destroy the Enterprise. We must survive at all costs. At all costs. We're engaging the enemy at Rennell Island. The Japanese are evacuating the Solomons, and we're bringing transports in. So there's plenty of targets on both sides. The USS Chicago is also present, and we're tasked with defending her as a priority. We expect her to be the primary target of the enemy.
Thank you.
Chicago is lost, but we got the bombers that sank her. Not much consolation.
We've incoming. We have airborne enemy forces approaching the Enterprise in large numbers.
Damn it! We committed too many planes to the Chicago. The Enterprise is practically defenseless.
There's nothing we can do.
We can always fight. We'll take what planes we can get. If the fighters are all launched, we'll take torpedo bombers and do what we can with them. Charlie squadrons armed with rockets. Everyone who can fly, find a plane and follow me.
Chicago went down. We saw in her our own fate, had the Enterprise's luck not held out. We rescued who we could and mourned the rest, Air Group Commander included. It's impossible to say whether the Enterprise would have been sunk if it weren't for the Air Group Commander's bravery. It's likely that hundreds of similar acts conspired to create her good luck throughout the summer of 1942. Courage and sacrifice were the stuff of the men of the Enterprise. Courage and sacrifice kept us afloat throughout the darkest days. Whatever held her up, the Enterprise refused to go down. We owe her, all of us who sailed on her, and everybody else as well. God bless you, Enterprise.